Hey everybody, today we're going to focus on solving for some of the problems that commonly come up in AI image generation, everything from blurry hands to weird artifacts. We'll talk about ways that you can fix each of those. We'll talk through step by step how to tackle those problems and really use the toolkit in Invoke to creatively problem solve in editing and retouching the image. Let's get started. So we are looking right now at this lovely image. Glimmer gave me a bunch of images with problems, and he said, these have problems, go figure out how to fix them. So that's what I'm gonna do today. But we're gonna start with this overwhelmingly pink image. I believe we actually even got this. Glimmer, correct me if I'm wrong, you got this from 4.0, right? You got this from ChatGPT, is that right? This is 4.0, the latest and greatest of OpenAI, which typically has a really, really good, like it's a great model. I don't have major complaints with the model, but even with it, you can get these kind of like strange things. So we're gonna like zoom in on the strangeness, right? Like the faces, that face right there, something's going wrong there. This guy's face is wrong. There's a lot of problems, right? The problem is not that it's pink. Some people are commenting on how pink it is. That is not the problem. That's certainly something you can fix. The problem is the faces and maybe tennis racket chairs. I think those are like the problems here. So we're gonna take this in. We're gonna take it into our canvas. Maybe what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a new canvas from the image. We'll do that as a raster layer. So the question often is going to be like, what tool is right for this job? In this case, what we're trying to do is we're trying to bring up detail on a couple of key areas, as well as kind of like eliminate some of the less desirable things. Let's see what Flux does, and then we'll compare it to SDXL, and we'll just kind of see which one we like better. So we'll start with Flux 1 Dev. We're gonna zoom in our bounding box on the faces here, and we're gonna say a pink-hued photograph featuring two women. One thing that I'll call out is on Flux, the guidance, and this is probably true for a lot of models. Guidance or CFG, both give more control over to the AI model in interpreting what's in the image based on what's there versus what's in your prompt. And what I mean by that is it'll kind of infer based on the existing image more of what it should be generating. And it might do a better job than you of kind of pulling out the assumption of how realistic it needs to be. Typically when you do this, especially on editing, when you're in painting, what you'll find is that you can get kind of like a higher quality, realistic aesthetic, right? It kind of just looks more crisp, but it does mean you need to play around with the denoising strength to make sure you're not changing it too much. So we're gonna come in. We're going to focus on this one and this one, and we're going to see what happens when we do just a tad of denoising. We'll just do like 0.35. Might change it a bit, but we're not going for like perfect control here. We're going for more of like the aesthetic. Okay, that's not too bad. I think faces have been largely like addressed there, right? They look a lot better. We'll just kind of continue moving along here and do that over and over again. So make this a little bit wider. A woman and a man in tennis attire, they're sitting at a table looking to the left side of the image. Okay, cool. We're going to in paint. And we'll do that same level of denoising there just to kind of like bring it in. And Flux does a relatively good job of kind of like blending it into the existing image. This guy looks like a clown. This looks like, look at this hat. Well, we're gonna take that clown there, and then we're gonna come over here and we're going to fix this lady who's got like a weird sideways hat. And then this lady right here. Two women in a tennis attire looking to the left side. That's pretty basic. This is just basic shrinking the bounding box to get more detail, doing a light denoising to get some of that kind of like revitalized using the model, and then pulling that back in. This one's a little bit less focused on, you know, making sure that everyone's looking at the right thing. So we've got these people over here looking in different ways, this person looking over here, and these people looking up. we're just going to accept that, because the goal here is to fix the faces and the details, not necessarily like get everyone looking in the same direction, which we could do. The other piece that we're going to try to fix here is going to be these like areas where there's random stuff we don't want, right? And so I'll just pull the bounding box back up here. There's a couple of areas where there's like floating stuff, right? We don't really want that. So I'm going to merge all of our layers together. And then we're going to try to figure out whether we want to do manual or automated infill. For this one, I'm just going to do automated, which means I'm just going to erase this raster layer, and I'm going to let Invoke kind of fill in the color there. I'm going to let it assume that. And, you know, we could even do flux fill if we want to try that. Let's try flux fill. Let's just see what happens. I'll also just do a comparison here with custom XL or SDXL, and we'll kind of do like an A-B test on those two. And I would say flux fill did a pretty decent job, right? Kind of just went in and did that thing and got rid of that tennis racket. So I think that's a success for flux fill. We'll give that one to flux fill. And we'll do the same over here. I'm just going to erase this one. And then I'm going to manually kind of like just paint over this part just to give ourselves like two tests. And we're going to kind of compare and contrast those. I will need to in paint over this area, but the one that is already emptied area there, we'll do flux fill again, and then we'll queue up a job with custom XL at about 0.55. All right, so flux fill seems to be adding something to the background. It's like a small dog, some other character, maybe. Flux fill, you have gone too far. Somebody said kids table back there. That's funny. We got flux fill. Oh my goodness. We're going to say that one didn't win. That one did not win. They're like tiny humans off in the distance. SDXL did fine. I would say there's a little bit of like jank that we probably want to work through there. There's like some like tweaks we'd probably want to make, maybe do another denoising pass, but you can see where we got a little bit more explicit control. We may have gone a little bit too far on that erasing though, because there's a little bit of blend there that's kind of messing up. Overall, there's some things I like about this, and there's some things that I like about the other one. What I'm going to do is I'm going to blend these two together just while we're here. Take our kids table, and we'll accept this one here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of like erase this piece here. Basically, like all the areas down here at the bottom that got a little bit messed up with the SDXL run. But ultimately, I think it looks pretty good. And then what we'll do is we'll just kind of overpaint that one more time. We'll do one pass with custom XL, and then we'll try one with Flux Dev just to see how they kind of compare. Somebody called out that there's a little bit of perspective weirdness. I think that's probably more of just like we in-painted one part and we need to kind of connect it up. And that part's, it's kind of already happening. Yeah, so Flux Dev, pretty decent perspective. It added a ball, I'm not sure why, but it kind of fits the spot. SDXL did fine. There's still a little bit of weirdness there, but actually I think I like the SDXL one better. It feels like it fits more with the image. I don't know if that's just me, but we're gonna take that. And then I'm just gonna one more time kind of in paint this one region, and we'll be done with this image. Oh, I just did that with Flux. It'll be fine. We'll see what Flux does. Okay, there's like some weirdness we could continue to fiddle with, but I don't want to spend too much time on this wall. Not the most important part. We got the faces. Faces are all better now. We've kind of like gotten control over this image. There aren't any weird tennis rackets everywhere. We can use this for whatever we want, right? So yay, we did it. We are going to move on. Problem number two that people often run into is going to be plasticky skin. How do we get rid of the plasticky skin? There's a couple of different ways that you can do it. We'll take this and do a new raster layer. And we've got this gentleman right here that we're going to play with. So in this case, there are a couple of things that you can do. Obviously, like we can try, you know, a man in a black jacket with black sunglasses. So we're going to try just little bit of touch up here. We'll do maybe like 0.25 or 0.3 with Flux Dev. I've got the guidance at 2. It should keep everything kind of like exactly the same because the denoising strength is lower, but it's going to kind of give a little bit more freedom for the model to apply this kind of more realistic texture to the image. In this case, my assumption is that we still got a little bit of plasticky. Now I'm using the base dev model, right? And so the base dev model has this plasticky kind of aspect to it. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a LoRa that was trained specifically to create more realistic skin. It's kind of like, this is the value of training custom models, right? Is you can inject more of what you're looking for. So if you're working on a specific style, you know, you've got a specific art style, you can include a LoRa that's going to push it more towards that. If you're working on realism, you can include a LoRa that's going to push it more towards that. Helping it understand the concepts that it's looking at, kind of giving it that freedom, will be very good. So we're going to try this and see what we get. Now we're going to compare this. So this was Flux Dev denoising low guidance. This is the before. This is with the realistic skin. So we're looking at some much improved, I would say on many dimensions, the hair looks more realistic. The skin certainly looks less plasticky. The jacket looks more realistic, like all across the board. Let's look at these hands. Oh my goodness. Look at the difference in those hands. The hands. I feel like I'm actually looking at this man's hands. So we've kind of like fixed that. Let's just see what happens if we go a little higher, just for science. We might get more of a change out of this. We might see better details. Hopefully it doesn't change too much. This was the 0.35. This one was the 0.45. Yeah, I'm sensing a little bit more like realism on this one, but we did start to get some more like changes, right? So like the top of this started stretching up. Things are starting to move around a little bit more, but you are getting some nice like detail out of it. So probably trade-offs, but I'm going to say that like 0.35 may have been our best one. So at least like in the middle there of keeping the structure and not changing it too much. So we'll call that one a success. I'll say that's like, that's good. Part of this is, again, just knowing like you don't have to make big changes to get these types of details, right? The details happen on those last few steps, the detailing steps, and that's going to happen right in the lower denoising strength where you're putting it through that last piece of the denoising process just over and over to get those details out. Let's actually take this. I'm curious to see what happens if we focus on just the face and also do this same technique, right? If we're going to do 0.35 again, we're just going to like see what happens if we add that detail just to one tiny area, because I foresee it doing really good work there, right? It's going to not just do that detailing, but it's also going to do that at a higher resolution. It's going to jam that pack in. Okay, let's see. Before and after. Before and after. I actually like it when it was just the whole image. I can see where this might be like more realistic in certain elements, right? Like it does look from a distance maybe more realistic. This is like still shiny, and this one's a little bit like softer. Somebody said better highlights on the glasses. Yeah, the glasses look a little bit cleaner, right? The glasses look more like realistic. He's not as shiny. So yeah, there's probably some benefit to this. You know, either way, I think we've got some options there. Let's see what happens when we do this with custom XL, and we'll do just a portrait photography prompt. And we'll do that same kind of like low denoising. We'll go a little bit lower on SDXL. We're going to do the same spot. Okay, so this is SDXL. That's Flux. SDXL, Flux. See, I like SDXL better for some of these detailing tasks, personally. I think that, it actually adds a lot to this that feels realistic, you know? And this is kind of where using different models for different tasks is really how you get the most out of it, right? Because you're able to kind of like use each one for where it's strong. 4.0 for getting like an entire composition of pink tennis players on a building, but then being able to go in and like detail things out with different models. It's like there's a lot to this. It's pretty clear to me that SDXL has a more realistic look up close. There's kind of an essence to it. It's hard to describe. And I mean, we definitely have this like Apple AirPod shaped earring or something like that that's coming out. It's like a diamond AirPod. Certainly don't know what that is. You know, while we're at it, we might as well fix that. So I'm gonna accept this. We're here for fixing problems, right? So I'm gonna add a raster layer. I'm gonna paint over this. Cool. So we're kind of like fixing that. And then I'll copy this raster layer to our in paint mask. And we'll do 0.2, something very light. We're given the freedom to the AI to kind of fix that, right? Okay, we're gonna need to turn that up a little bit. Looks like he has ear chewed off. Man, we need to prompt for this earring. A single diamond earring. I think that this looks fine. It at least doesn't look like an AirPod anymore. We're gonna go with that. And now we've got like a much better looking gent. We're gonna merge that, delete all the middle layers, and then do kind of like a little bit of a before and after. Whoa. Wow, look at that difference right there. It's wild. This looks so much better. This one looks like a PlayStation era 3D model, and this one looks like a great fashion model. Yeah, great. Okay, we did it. We got that one fixed. Plasticky skin solved. We'll call that it for today. Journeys in AI. You're always learning. You're always rolling the dice. You're always kind of like moving forward. Today, we have moved forward. So we're going to continue on this journey next week, and we'll see you all there. Take care.